All right, guys, I thought I'd give it a crack at doing a quick tutorial on how to change out the original clickety-clackety big buttons on the AES stick for some 24 millimeter Sanwa push button snap-ins. And let's give it a shot, and we'll try and follow along as I take this apart. So I've already removed the back side of this stick, and this is the internals. Haven't done anything but take the back off so far. See, here's the back panel here. Removed four anti-slip pads covering four screws here, and there's a fifth screw in the middle. Let's take a quick look. So I'm not going to do anything with the stick. I like the stick. I'm just going to, I'll actually change out the ball top, but that's extremely simple. What I'm going to do here is mainly concerned with this. So this whole thing is part of the buttons and button assembly. So what we'll have to do is, you'll see, it's nice and simple. It's all labeled. See, here's D, C, B, and A. Those are the activation wires, and then the ground wires are up here. You see, there's one hooking up here, another one here, another one here. And the reason why there's three is they all kind of interconnect. I think probably one goes to the stick, one goes to the start and select up here, another one is shared amongst all the buttons. So that's really the trickiest part. So what we'll do now is turn on the soldering iron, get that heated up, and what we'll do is we'll take note of the different colors here with a piece of paper and a pen, and we'll remove this by taking off these four screws, and next after that we'll start desoldering these pads go from there. So let me just show you how this works, and I'll remove these four screws here, pull that off, and show you what that looks like real fast. Let's pause. Okay, so you can see I've removed those four screws on the button assembly, and then it just lifts out like so. So those are what those clickety-clackety buttons look like. And these are actually pretty decent condition ones. So I'm going to do my best to just, kind of do no harm and just kind of desolder these pads nice and neat, and really just do my best to, put the original parts in a Ziploc, put it in the parts bin, just in case, you never know. All right, so to desolder pads, we're just gonna use one of these. This is a little solder sucker thing. And we've got kind of setups. This is kind of what I've been using. I'm no, professional modder here, but here's the solder I'm using. I've got one of these nice kind of copper scrilly things to remove solder from the end of my solder pen. And I've just got kind of this adjustable temperature Radio Shack brand soldering iron. And the best way I've found to remove solder is to kind of add a bit of solder to the end of the pen. With the new solder on the pen, add it to this, and then when that gets liquefied, hit it with a solder sucker. And you know what? It's going to be pretty hard for me to do this on camera, but I'll do my best. One second. Okay, here goes nothing. So, I've got it kind of propped up here, and with my solder, I'm just going to just add a little bit to the pen. You're going to want to try not to breathe any of this stuff in. And with this solder sucker, I'm going to pump it up. You see it just spat out a bunch from another job I just finished up. I'm going to just add it with the new solder on the pen to the pad, and you'll see it start to move. That's when we want to jump in. Bingo! See those two wires pop off? Okay, and then you just kind of rinse and repeat. So we'll do the next pair. You want to remember to just keep track of what color went where. So I've written that down. Add it to the heat. Oh, you see that one just fell off. Let's try going for the next one. Yep. Oh, I didn't pump it up. Too much heat. There you go. Next one over here. Oh, see, it's starting to look fine. This is super. Those are nice big pads to work with. So actually, you can just heat them up and nudge them off. Okay. And checking the camera, we're still in position, so I'm just going to continue with these ground wires. And these are a little older, stiffer, little kind of older joints. Oh, that one was popped off too. Let's keep going. I want to burn the wire. Just add a little bit of heat. I've got my solder sucker primed, pumped in case I need it. A little tougher of an angle here. Boom, got it. One more. You see what I'm doing? You're looking at a wire, huh? Alright, well, we're at the last one. This is just the last of the three ground wires on that button assembly. And it's being a little slower because I don't have any kind of fresh solder to add to it. That's kind of the easy way. But it is going here. See? Not an expert. I'm going to clean off my iron and the stuff, and I'm just going to, got to use two hands. Now it's just going to add a little bit more so that I just get it done fast. Alright. Bingo. Gone. Okay. That's a quick how-to on removing solder. I'll pause here and kind of go on my game plan of what we're going to do next. Okay, so have the buttons removed, or the button assembly removed. I'm just going to take my new buttons, and what I'm going to try and do is I'm going to pop them in, and I'm going to try and line them up going down like... So, because what I want to do is I want to take a bare piece of wire and daisy chain the grounds all in a nice line so it looks nice and clean. And then on the last one, we're going to end it and we're going to jab three of those ground wires all on the last button. And then we'll take, the other wire and just solder them to their respective prongs of the button there. So this is the fun part here, where we just take our button, send it in from the other end. It looks like a good angle there. Boop. See, they work really well. The 24 millimeter snap-ins just nothing to it. And this is the, like I said, aside from playing with it when you've finally done it, this is the fun part here. Doink. And one more. Okay, and I'll cut here and I'll show you how we're gonna do this. All right, just quickly, I'm going to show you what I did off camera. Is I have this 22 gauge solid core wire, and I cut it, and I just kind of in inch increments just stripped it all the way. So I've just got this kind of bare piece of wire, and what I'm going to try and do is solder it to the end and just kind of weave it through the prongs. And I'll cut right now, and I'll show you what that looks like when it's all finished up. And again, the last one, we're going to have to feed this. We're going to solder this along with the three ground wires there to the last button, so that they'll all be in line in the circuit. So, all right, I'll cut here. Okay, just finished the ground wire daisy chaining of the the wire there. Let's see if we can get it to focus. Oh, come on. It's not gonna want to do it. It's too okay, so you see, I just took the exposed copper wire, threaded it through one of the holes of the push buttons there, of the prong, gave it a kink at the end, applied solder. The way I did that is basically put your iron on the prong and then just, you know, kind of feed the solder coil into it. So just kind of should just, and then lift your solder pen up, and bingo, you got a nice joint. So see here, this went through. Okay, and now here's the messy one. So you've got to kind of twist these three ground wires together, and terminate the end of the daisy chain there. So I'm just going to bend this back here and give it a clip, and that'll be done with the ground wires. Okay, I'll get that later. Okay, so that is the kind of oh shit stage of the operation, and this one doesn't look the best, but it's kind of hard to, you know, do four things into one prong. And you know, is that the best solder work? Oh man, it won't even focus. My camera is not being cooperative. Hell no, that's terrible. But it is kind of solid as a rock, and all this stuff is very solid. And you know, I like doing it this way for, you know, just the reason when you're pounding on those buttons, you know, you don't want, I don't know, something to come loose in your quick disconnect, you know, threading there. I don't know. When I can, I like to solder them hardwired, my wires for push buttons. Okay, and just kind of on the home stretch, I'll do here to here, and then gray goes to C. I'm sorry, gray goes to C. Terrible video. I don't know how Luke Morse does this. Gray to C, and then B is yellow. So put the yellow one there, and A into A. I mean, white into A. And I'll do that really quickly, and we'll come back when it's done. All right, guys, last step here. So I still got the back off, but I plugged in the controller. And we're just going to see and make sure that this works. Start button works. Let's do some training. There we go. Left and right work, up, down work. The A button works. And let's do the cheat real quick. Can we do the cheat? Uh, Oh, damn it. I hit the wrong one by accident. Okay, so A button. Yep, B button. Working. C button kick. D repel. All right, awesome. So we've got start works, select works, up, down, left, right. All right, awesome. Very cool. All right, let's switch out the ball top while we're at it. Okay, 1 second. Okay, step two. Fire up, dog. All right, so if you made it this far and you don't know how to do this, I don't know what's up, but you can see for the ball top. See, there's a spot for a flathead screwdriver. You want to just put it there and then twist on the other side. So 1 second. All right, guys, job's a good one. Just got a nice, super quick responding. I mean, let's be honest, they're pretty clickety-clackety too, but far less travel than the old buttons here, which, you know, I mean, pretty good, but this will be really fast. Also, added just a full-size black ball top. And like I said, I'm keeping all the old parts just in case anybody needs them or, you know, want to, you know, gift them to somebody, probably, whatever. I'll just keep them safe. And, in the meantime, we got, cool games to play and a nice stick to do it with. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed the video and, thanks for bearing with me. Hope this was a help to someone and I'll talk to y'all later. Take care.